Alice begins with my own emotions. I do have a good memory for almost every year of school, probably because something humiliating and embarrassing happened in every year. And that's, I can remember that was the year that this happened and that was the year that that happened. And that's really was the basis of the Alice books when they began, all the embarrassing things that, and of course girls then write in with my Alice moment, they call it, and they tell me how they handled it. And it just grew into a whole lifetime of a girl, and I hope that that comes through. Well, when I wrote the first Alice book, there was no thought that this would be a series. I just wanted to write about a motherless girl who is being raised by her father and older brother who don't know diddly about bringing up a girl, and that's where the humor comes in. But reviewers kept saying, Alice's many fans will await her next adventures, and I said, what? So I thought about it and told the editor that I would do a series if she could get older in every book, that I did not want to be stuck in a sitcom where the same birthdays, everything was going on. Then when I started realizing that I was getting 3 months out of, I was getting 3 books out of every year of her life, I had to figure out how old I was going to be when she got to be 18. And, you know, that's, I've been writing them for 25 years, and you have to have sort of faith in your health and all the rest. And I thought, once she gets to college, and because I never had the experience of being a live-in student at college, I don't think I would be capable maybe of doing a good job of her college years, and where they hang out, the things they do would not be the same. So I thought, I can get her through high school pretty well, and then after that, kids will, they say, did she ever marry Patrick? Did she ever have children? What did she become? So I thought, okay, I'll do one last book in which each, she starts out at 18, and then every 10 years or 5 years, the next big thing that comes in her life, I'll jump to that. And it worked. I just picked out the things that would show her development, show all the things that I think are important. In the very last book, all the kids in her seventh grade class, or many of them, are supposed to come back and open the time capsule that they buried and read the letters that they wrote to their 60-year-old selves when they were back in seventh grade. And so many kids have said, will we ever see that? Will they come back and will they read those letters? And I've assured them that will be in the final book, but that's all they know. So it's going to be fun when that comes out.